that's basically it. Like you sit in silence and you just allow these thoughts to come forward. Step into a world where there's no one there. Buku, buku, island of
A lot of you guys are confused about how to get in the zone and how it comes about. If you followed this channel for a long time, I always talk about being smooth and being in the rhythm of the game. In the Basketball Brain program at night, we recommend you do some mindfulness. You can also do it in the morning as well, but we wanted to work in visualization with mindfulness. And with mindfulness, what you're doing is you're learning to let thoughts arise and fall, arise and fall. Let the thoughts take you where they will. And by doing this, you start to understand that before a game, for instance, you feel nervousness. Well, you realize through mindfulness that that nervousness can come up and you can just let it go. You can let go of any thought. And from a certain perspective, no thought is bigger or smaller than any other thought. The thought of a ladybug crawling on a flower and your thoughts about your performance, they're both just thoughts and you can let them go. So before a game, you might be worrying about how you're going to perform, worrying about the people watching. Through mindfulness, you learn to let those go. You learn to let go of those thoughts, to make thoughts slippery. And by so doing, as you let go of thoughts, what emerges is the present moment. And when the present moment emerges, you've entered into now o'clock, I like to call it. What time is it? Now o'clock. Showtime. Right now.
In 2000, we had a new head coach that came to the Los Angeles Lakers by the name of Phil Jackson. And Phil was just coming off of winning 6 championships with the Bulls. And he was really big on mindfulness and really big on meditation. And it wasn't an option for us. So we'd sit in our film room and he'd turn the lights out and we would meditate as a group. And he'd teach us mindfulness. And it really connected with me because he was teaching mindfulness through something that I was extremely passionate about, which was the game of basketball. So it was told through the lens of, this is going to help you here. And so I had this curiosity about it. And that was my introduction to meditation.
And the more you can get into now o'clock, the more often you're going to play in the zone. Your body moves effortlessly. Your coordination is at heightened levels. You feel comfortable in hostile environments. You feel comfortable with a cheering crowd, a crowd that's there egging you on, and you feel comfortable in a crowd that wants you to lose and perform badly. You feel comfortable with people wanting you to perform well, and you feel comfortable around people who want you to fail, your haters and doubters. Why? Because haters, doubters, pressure, wanting to succeed, not wanting to fail. What are all those? It's just thoughts. And if you practice mindfulness, you can let these thoughts arise and fall away, arise and fall away. And as you do so, you start to enter again into that zone, that beautiful flow state where things move in slow motion, where you have superhuman hand-eye coordination, where you almost have, I know it sounds crazy, telekinesis. I know it sounds crazy, but I can't tell you how many athletes I've talked to in a variety of sports that the ball comes off their hand wrong, be it a quarterback or a basketball player, or they hit the ball a little off and they feel mentally to move the ball. I've had that experience. Now, if you're somebody who's of a more materialist mindset, you can assume the subconscious mind already made the adjustments before the ball actually left your hand. But I'm not discounting those who feel like when they're in that present moment, they have superhuman powers. When you're in that present moment, you also seem to have the power of telling the future. What do I mean by that? Athletes in the zone have the ability to anticipate. Wayne Gretzky famously said, "The other guys skate to where the puck is, I skate to where the puck's going to be." You're so in tune with the game, you know what's coming next. You're so in tune with the rhythm of the game, you know what the beat's going to be next. Have you ever heard a song that you've never heard before and you were so into the song, you knew when the song's bass was going to drop? You knew when certain instruments were going to come in or the chorus was going to come in and you had never heard the song before. You start to develop that with the sport you play. Getting into the present moment by letting go of the thoughts you don't want, the feelings you don't want. That allows you to slip into that present moment where all of these supernatural, they seem supernatural anyways, these supernatural abilities arise within you. And you become the very best version of yourself. You're able to compete at levels you didn't think you were able to compete at before. You may give yourself chills with some of the things you've done. I remember as I learned to get into the state when I was playing basketball, I made a lot of backward shots in high school. I would go into the paint and like flip it over my shoulder and in. Now I'd practice these a lot, but I remember when I first started doing this, and it'd go in, I would give myself chills. I'm not saying that as like an egotistical thing. It's just the subconscious mind is so fast. By the time the conscious mind figures out what you did, you're impressed with yourself, okay? I've had games where I, you know, when I first started playing basketball, I had 17 points in a quarter, 23 points in a quarter. And it was because I was in the now o'clock. There wasn't a hope I would make the shot. There was an expectation, a knowing that the shot would go in. And I can converse this with the games I played bad. When I had a bad stretch, I was more conscious. Some thoughts were sticking. Some doubts maybe were sticking. And you have to learn to let go of those. I'll end with this. Sometimes what you need to release is just a low-level, subtle feeling of doubt or being uncertain. It's not a fully formed level verbally or even pictorially in your mind. It's just this vague feeling that's there. And if you can subtly feel that and notice that your mind secretly is grabbing it and you can let that go, you will start to find the zone more. That little voice within you that maybe is not a voice yet. It's kind of like there's a part of your mind that just gives you a weird look like you can't do this. A doubting look like you can't do this. If you can let go of that, you'll find that those subtle emotions, you'll find yourself going into the present moment.
That's basically it. Like you sit in silence and you just allow these thoughts to come forward and you get a chance to observe the self and things that may be lying beneath the surface that if you don't have that time to sit quietly on your own, you'll never pay attention to.
You can do this with anything, with school, with sports, in a relationship. Letting go of all thoughts and entering into now o'clock. I'll give you a quick visualization. I always say I'm gonna end on one thing and I always give you one more thing. In the new Basketball Brain program that's coming, as well as my personal programs I make for people in other areas of life, one way to help you learn mindfulness, to let go of things, is imagine your brain, imagine your mind like a bunch of little hands. And what your mind does is these little hands just grab onto every thought that come through. And something you can visualize is all the hands that make up your brain slash mind. Just imagine a jumble of hands. Just imagine them going limp, loose, and letting all the thoughts and feelings flow through without grabbing. I often do this. I imagine my brain is like a pair of hands or a bunch of hands grabbing some thought. Then I imagine those hands opening and letting the thought and the feeling flow through and not holding on to it, just going with the flow, so to speak. And what's interesting, when you do that, your willpower also is strengthened, because from that present moment state with no extraneous emotions that are like a ballast holding you down, with no thoughts distracting you, get this superhuman concentration. And then when you use your will, there's nothing blocking your will. Sometimes when we use our will, a bunch of emotions start hanging on to our will and blocking it, getting in the way of it. But when you let go of all of that and then use your will, nothing's blocking your will. Okay? So learn to be mindful. Mindful means you're aware of your mind so you can let go of your mind. It's really a letting go technique. It's releasing all thoughts until you enter into the present moment and you enter into the flow state. One might say you step into a world where there's no one else and you actually are with the very, very best when you're in that present moment. Step into a world where there's no one.
awesome.
Make sure you hit up basketballbrain.com and also check out the Mamba Protocols. This lesson is a lesson from that program. It's a mini program. It's a great add-on. It's a great add-on to the Basketball Brain program. There's nothing like it that's ever been made. It delves into Kobe Bryant's mind in a way that's never been seen before. And I use a lot of interviews and other things from his life to really paint a picture of his mentality, and it'll help you develop that mentality in yourself. The Mamba Protocols, the link's in the description.